Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back into the Homegrown Happy Hour podcast. Right now in the studio sitting across from me, Jason Garrett and Stephen Lowe, Tulane's home. How y'all boys doing?
All right, how you doing?
We're doing fine. How are you doing today?
Doing good. It's a pleasure to finally have y'all in here, and I'm really jealous of the shirt, man. Where'd you get that thing?
I think I ordered it online, probably eBay or somewhere.
Yeah, eight.
You can't beat.
That's where it's all at nowadays, you know? Making Jeff Bezos and all of them just a little bit richer.
Yep. You
know?
Yeah.
What kind of guitars y'all got in here today?
That's a Gibson Hummingbird.
Mm. That's a pretty guitar, man.
Thank you, man.
And you told me yours earlier.
Yeah, it's an Epiphone Masterbuilt.
Hmm. How many guitars do y'all have?
I've got three.
We're about four.
Okay.
Yeah, I've got a couple of just their project guitars that I'm working on that I've been redoing. And one is an old Magnum 12-string that our granny had back years ago, and I'm trying to redo it and get it back in working condition.
See, I'm stupid when it comes to guitars and all that. This is where I'm kind of good. But what is, like, the need for a 12-string? Like, they sound good, don't get me wrong, but, like, I don't know. What's the purpose for a 12-string?
Well, that's probably a good question because I don't know myself. I just know they sound good. I just know they sound good.
Hey, they do. They do.
Yeah.
I wonder whatever came first. Was it like the 6-string or the 12-string? That'd be an interesting Google right there.
I would say the 6.
You would think. Have y'all ever like got crazy and just got like a ukulele or something?
No. I tried to play a mandolin once. I didn't.
Yeah, my dad, he had a mandolin, and he tried to teach me one time, and I just, it wasn't happening. Yeah,
that's one thing that's kind of tough, especially if you have big fingers.
I got huge hands, and yeah, that's what got me.
That's where my issue comes in, too.
Yeah, them things have like 36 strings, it seems like sometimes. But yes, it's a pleasure to have y'all in. Tulane's Home. I love the name. That's a really awesome band name. How did that come to fruition?
Well, that probably would have been on my part. Where we live at in David, it's on 850. I don't know if anybody's familiar, you know, with that place. But if you come in through Prestonsburg side, you can come to my house. I can go out 850 and go to Allen Central on 80. So either way, I'm in and out. It's, either lane brings me to my house.
Yeah.
So that's how I came up with the Tulane's Home.
It just kind of like, it was like a eureka moment for you one day or something?
Yeah.
Huh.
Yeah, it just kind of hit me.
Yeah, it's weird how that kind of happens with the universe. Just that idea spark, you know? Yeah.
And me, I think it's a kind of catchy name. But
I do too. I mean, it's different. You've never heard a band being named after a road. Before. Yeah. Yep. And I know that it's mainly you and your son, Matthew. When have you started with them?
Probably about 3 weeks ago, maybe. A month at best.
Wow, that's... Yeah. So have y'all kind of known each other for a while?
No,
or how did
we're
y'all
family.
Partner? We're family, yeah.
Okay.
He's our cousin. He'd been playing, too, and we'd been playing, doing our thing, and then it just worked out that he ended up with us, so...
Yeah, so y'all are the Tulane's Home, and you're like exit 23 or route 119.
Hitchhiker.
Yeah, he's the hitchhiker.
But yeah, so what made you want to add a third person to the group?
Well, we've been wanting to add another one for a while, and since he's family and we know what he sounds like, he can play good. Got a pretty good voice on him, you know. So
yeah.
We figured he'd be a good mix in the band, so
yeah.
He wanted to play with us too, so we made it happen.
Nice. And it's so cool that y'all have like a you're all family too. Is that something that kind of helps the band in a way, you think?
Well, that helps a whole lot.
So how long have you been playing now for? How long has Tulane's Home been a thing?
We've been playing probably about 2 years.
Wow.
That we've actually been out in public playing.
Yeah. Were y'all in bands before this, or was this kind of your first thing?
Yeah, I was I was playing someone else here, yeah, for probably 3 years, I guess, something like that.
Yeah, I'd played in bands, but it'd been like years ago. I was probably like in high school or something. You know, we had a little thing, but I didn't play for a lot of years. And then my boy got old enough to start playing, and me and him, he played with the Mountain Arts Center. He was in the junior pros for a couple of seasons. Then after he got out of that and couldn't go back, then we decided we were going to start doing our own thing and start playing. So
nice.
We made that happen. We started getting out.
Yeah, I mean, y'all have started at quite a unique time right now in the entertainment industry. I know a lot of y'all, you do a lot of videos on Facebook. And that's something I think is very cool for bands to do. Because, you might be playing at the Jenny Wiley Festival or whatever it is, but thousands of people can watch you on Facebook as well.
Yeah, we like to, most of the time if we play anywhere, we like to do live. Mm-hmm. So live that way, so people, you know, at home, people can't get out, they can sit at home and watch us.
Yeah.
Enjoy it the same way.
Have y'all been pretty busy here with all of this craziness going on this year? Have you been doing quite a few shows?
It's actually been kind of slow.
Yeah, it has been for a lot of people.
Yeah.
So what is it that y'all do besides music? Do you have another job or any hobbies or anything like that?
Yeah. My dad and I have got a body shop and towing service.
You've probably towed me before.
There's a chance. You don't drive illegal, do you?
No. We ain't going to talk about that. But
No.
I'm playing her out. But, So what's the name of the towing service there?
Cow Creek Auto Body and Towing.
Somebody else, thank God.
Yeah.
What about you, brother?
Me, I work on reclamation. I work for GMS. I do a lot of reclamation work, cleaning ponds up on strip jobs.
I'm dumb. I don't know what reclamation means.
Doing a cleanup and everything on the strip job after they went in, they strip and everything. You go in and put everything back. And
so you're like just a hillbilly janitor, basically.
That's what it is.
You're cleaning it all up. Yeah.
They go in and make a mess, and I come behind them and clean it back up.
How long have you been doing that for?
I've probably been here for about 2 years.
Okay.
Going on my second. Well, this would be my second year.
Around this area?
Yeah.
Oh, so are y'all originally from Eastern Kentucky?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Personally,
okay.
Right.
Yeah, we born and raised.
Nice. A beautiful area, especially this time of year right now with the fall colors and everything around. It's pretty. So I know that y'all mainly do country music. What if you were to describe your style of music to somebody out there, how would you describe it?
Go ahead.
I don't know. It'd be hard to describe, actually. I wouldn't know how to even start. But
So you mainly do country. Do you like do classic rock, anything like that?
We do a little bit of everything.
Yeah, I loved y'all's cover of Call Me the Breeze, Leonard Skinner. We were talking about that earlier. That's my favorite Leonard Skinner song.
Yeah, that's probably
one of
ours too. So.
Yeah. It's cool, though, how you kind of put your own little twist on it like that. Do you do mainly covers or throw some originals in there every once in a while?
For the most part, it's covers. He's the original guy.
Yeah.
I write the originals, and I guess mine's what I write and stuff. It's probably going to sound like, you know, older stuff because that's what I grew up on. I mean,
yeah.
The old classics. You got the Waylon and Haggard and all that bunch. I mean,
yeah, and that's the good stuff right there.
I try to write something close to what they would do. Try to keep that stuff alive because that's the good stuff.
Yeah. See, what you need now is a fourth member, so it's a four lane road, which makes it a highway, and y'all are just the new highwaymen at that point.
Right.
Well, we just recently bought a set of drums. We just got to find somebody who knows how to play them.
Hey, everybody out there, if you want to join a band, why not?
Yeah, we have
a bass player. We could use a bass player too.
Use a bass player. We have a nice set of drums, so we can find us a drummer. We don't have to worry about having the drums. We're set and ready.
Hey, y'all been sounding good, though, just the way that y'all have been doing things. I seen, that Call Me the Breeze video, y'all were playing on a, I don't even know what those things are called. That 18-wheelers pull behind them, I guess.
Yeah.
What are those things called? Am I stupid?
A low boy kind of.
Is that really?
It kind of is.
Low boy?
Yeah.
I don't think that I've ever asked what trailer, those yeah, things are called.
Equipment trailer. Fifth wheel trailer. That'd be.
Fifth wheel trailer?
Yeah.
That'll work.
Yeah, that sounds good. Nobody's here to tell us we're wrong.
Yeah, nobody's here. They can comment later and tell us.
So what's the most unique place that you've played music? I'd say that that's a pretty good one.
That's one of them for sure.
Yeah, see, I liked the.
It's not very often you get to play on the back of a truck or anything.
Hey, but it worked, man, and it's sounding good. See, that's one cool thing about, times are very hectic right now and crazy, but that's one cool thing that's come about this is people, especially musicians or just entertainers in general, have found unique ways to still play music. I mean, who would have thought that y'all would be playing on a low boy or whatever y'all call those things? But it works.
Yep.
And we found that out. It took a pandemic for us to find that out, but we found it out.
Yeah. It doesn't matter unless we play anywhere.
Yeah, I seen the y'all played at a family cooking event just the other day, right?
Yeah,
chili dinner. That's where a guy I used to work with. He asked us to play. That's pretty fun too.
Yeah. So if anybody has just a birthday or a chili dinner or anything they want y'all to play at, they can just hit you up and you come down.
Yeah, we're not picky about what we play. We'll play for anything. Birthday parties, dinner, chili dinners. I mean, we don't care.
Yeah, and sometimes that's the coolest thing. I mean, you can play the Mountain Arts Center or whatever it is, and that's awesome. But whenever you play those little hole-in-the-wall places or just a little small event like that, there's a special atmosphere in gigs like that.
Yeah. The most fun I've ever had was at a birthday party. They had a house party.
Oh wow! I'd say
it was all right.
How old was the person turning? What kind? Was it an adult birthday party?
Oh yeah. They were having a good time.
Yeah, man. Like I said, those gigs right there are fun. It kind of means a little bit more to the people. It makes it more interactive. It's nice.
Yeah, I probably enjoy playing smaller like that than I do if I was out in a big crowd. Really, just my opinion.
Yeah. Well, that's been the case for me, because I do stand-up comedy and stuff, and I've done pretty decent-sized gigs, but, man, the most fun that I've ever had was this, little hole-in-the-wall bar. It ain't really a hole-in-the-wall, and I'm not trying to talk bad about it. Big shout-out to the Hideout in Parkersburg, West Virginia. I love that place. But, yeah, there's only, 30, 25 people in the crowd, something like that. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, everybody else thought it was going to be a disaster, but that was one of the funnest nights we've ever had. And I've been on stage in front of 1,000 people before and have more fun just sitting in a crowd with 30 people, You don't have to in this business, I like to have more fun than worry about, getting popular or famous or rich or whatever. It's about having fun.
Yeah, that's what we like to do. We like to have fun. I don't care if one or two people are listening. I'm going to get up there and have fun with it anyways, because if I can make one or two people enjoy it, I'm fine.
Yeah. Well, whenever you stop having fun in this type of business, that's it's easy to get lost in that. You have to be doing it for the right reasons. Yeah. So for Two Lanes Home, have y'all been working on any recordings or anything like that, or are you just trying to focus on shows right now?
I haven't really been working on anything just yet. I have a few songs that I've written and stuff that I want to eventually try to do something with. But right now, we just must have been doing the shows, just getting out and playing. So,
yeah, y'all got two shows coming up, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We have one coming up on the 15th. It's a new place, Pikeville, Clarissa's Country Bar and Grill. And then we have the 21st would be at the Brick House in Prestonsburg.
Love the Brick House, man.
Oh, yeah, some great food.
Yeah, we were talking about them wings earlier.
Yeah, apple bourbon wings.
Yeah, man. Have y'all seen the thing that they were, this is pre-recorded for anybody who hasn't figured that out at this point, but have y'all seen the thing that they were doing this week with the pea burger stuff?
Yeah.
Woo! I forget who it was, but they put fried green tomatoes on a burger.
That almost sounds like the Brick House.
It might have been them. They released the whole menu. But Jenny Wiley, they put buffalo on a burger. They had a buffalo burger. Like actual real buffalo, not no buffalo sauce or anything like that. We're talking real buffalo here, people.
Put the buffalo on there.
That's some good stuff. Have y'all ever tried buffalo or anything like that?
No.
No, I've not had tried buffalo.
Tried kangaroo jerky once.
What? Yeah. Where did you try kangaroo?
Florida.
Is that?
Yeah,
that's definitely Florida.
Not for me.
Yeah.
Not for me. No.
Florida's like, yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. As soon as you say Florida, people's like, okay, I get it. Yeah.
But the only thing I've really tried is probably off, like that would be alligator.
I love alligator, man. Oh, it's so good. It's like the sweetest chicken you'll ever taste in your entire life. What does kangaroo taste like?
Not good. Not good.
The weirdest thing, the nastiest thing I guess I've ever tried is probably squid. Chewy. Ugh, yuck.
Actually, I think I tried that at a restaurant in Ashland. It's squid.
Yeah, I forget what they call it. They have a special name for it.
It was fried. I don't know how you ate it, but this was fried, and it was kind of almost like trying to chew a rubber ball or something. It wasn't.
I was holding the tentacle in my hand. No fried or nothing. Just, oh, man. One time, never again. Kind of like the kangaroo meat, you know. Hey, people need to get. I used to be a really picky eater, man, but you got to. The world can end at any moment at this point. You got to eat what you can find out there, folks.
Yeah, I'll try about anything. Worst you do is not like it.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, I've tried a rattlesnake before. Y'all ever tried a rattlesnake?
No, I haven't. My dad has. He actually likes it.
Yeah. Same thing with mine.
He actually killed one a while back. I did. We did in Jackson where I was working at. And I skinned it right on the job site and brought it home and fried it.
I haven't had it fried. I just had just wasn't fried. But it was, I'd say fried would be a little bit better than the way I had it.
Made my little mix, whatever, rolled it in it, egg, buttermilk, and flour and cornmeal, whatever, and deep fried in peanut oil. It was good.
Actually,
there's not a lot of meat on them, but you have to pick at it, but it's good.
Yeah. It was all right. The way I ate it didn't have a lot of flavor to it. Maybe that way it'll have a little bit more flavor.
Yeah.
So I still want to get back to the kangaroo meat because that just blows my mind. Did you buy it at like a grocery store?
Yeah, they had a little jerky store. Like it was all jerky.
And wow.
They had about anything you wanted, and for some reason I went with the kangaroo jerky.
Well, hey, I don't blame you. I mean, who would ever get a chance to try kangaroo? Florida's just a special place.
No doubt.
What? I don't know if it's the heat. I don't know if it's alligators. Like, I don't know what drives them so crazy. And I have family in Florida, and they even say they're crazy, so nobody can talk bad about me. Really, you get on the news, and you never hear about, like, Nebraska man or Wyoming man. Nothing. Right. It's always Florida man. Right. Florida man, Florida man, Florida man. Yeah. It's that state is crazy.
You hear a lot about Huntington too, though. So just throwing it out there.
That's the West Virginia's Florida right there.
Yeah.
Well, we're on the subject.
But I've only been to Huntington a few times, and I had a good time every time I go. I can tell y'all some stories off air, though.
Oh, yeah.
So, do y'all have like a kind of a favorite place to play at or anything like that?
No, not really. Don't really have a favorite.
Yeah, see, like West Virginia is kind of one of my favorite states to do anything in. I don't know, them people, other than Huntington, they're a lot of fun. They're a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Hey, just playing around, Huntington. We love you.
Yeah, we've been playing around. You're mainly just local. Mm-hmm. Here recently, I've been trying to reach out to some other areas like Moorhead, Mount Sterling, and
yeah,
and of course Pikeville or Paintsville, anywhere we can get into play, just because the way things are going right now, it's kind of getting hard to find anywhere to even play. So
yeah, and it just keeps getting crazier as we go. It seems like
yeah, so we're trying to expand out a little bit and get find some other places to get in and out and play.
Yeah, and that's what a lot of artists are having to do. They're having to go hours away to find a paying gig to play at.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's I'm optimistic. I think that, you know, sooner or later, the rain's going to go away and you get the rainbow.
Yeah.
And I think that everybody, the fans and especially us entertainers, will enjoy getting out and doing a gig so much more than we ever have before.
Yeah.
It's a... almost like we took everything for granted.
Yep.
Yeah.
And when it does, you know, like you said, when it comes out of it, everything go back, we'll be a lot more appreciative of everything that we do have and get to do. So
yeah,
I think everybody will enjoy things a whole lot more.
Yeah, I haven't been to like a legit concert since March or something like that.
February.
Yeah. And I had all these... I had so many tickets to see so many great bands this year because 2020 was supposed to be like when all these great bands were coming back. Like, well, I had tickets to go see Rage Against the Machine, the Black Crowes. I always wanted to see the Black Crowes.
Yeah, I love Black Crowes.
And this was my chance. And yeah, all up in smoke, you know.
Last one was Sturgill Simpson, Tyler Childers.
Jealous.
In Lexington.
Pretty awesome. Jealous. I was going to, I seen a ticket that was like to the left of the stage. It was like $80. I was this close to getting it. Yeah. And my wife had to work that night. Oh, yeah. Broke my heart.
It was good.
What do y'all think of Sturgill's new bluegrass album?
I love it.
It's good stuff.
I love it.
Sturgill's just on a totally different level. So speaking about Jackson, you know, that's a... that man, I like Tyler, you know, but I'm more of a Sturgill fan. I know that I'm going to get so many comments about that one right there. But Sturgill, he's just, you can't keep him in a box.
No.
Like, yeah, his last album was like a psychedelic rock album that he teamed up with Netflix and made an anime movie with, like the Samurai End of the World movie with a psychedelic rock album. And then just 4 months later, he comes out with a bluegrass album.
Where's he going to go next?
I love artists like that, that you can't, you don't know. Because you have some people, they're like, every song just sounds the same. You know, and it's, for some people that works, like AC/DC, they've been making the same song since the 1960s.
Yeah.
And it works. That's AC/DC. That's what you would expect. But whenever you have somebody that can kind of just get creative and go outside the box and do something that's never been done before, it's interesting.
Yeah.
And Sturgill is definitely one of them guys. But I do believe, though, that Eastern Kentucky's kind of... just the whole Appalachian area, but especially Eastern Kentucky, is bringing back not just bluegrass music, but country music as a whole. I mean, it's almost like it's all just under one big umbrella. Yeah. So what song will you be performing for us today?
You want to do one of the covers? If you want to, that we got picked, and then I'll do an original next time.
Yeah, people like covers.
Yeah.
How many times do y'all hear... play Freebird at a show?
I've heard a few times. Luckily, I can't hear real good.
Yeah, that or Wagon Wheel.
Yeah.
that makes sense.
That's like the go-to for everybody. Holler, Wagon Wheel.
For anybody who's a Bob Dylan fan out there, one time at a show, somebody screamed out at Bob Dylan, play Freebird at one of his shows, and him and his band cranked out Freebird. And it was awesome. Yeah. So yeah, if anybody's interested in hearing Bob Dylan do Freebird, it's on YouTube. Go check it out. But what's the cover y'all are going to do today?
It's a song by Little Texas. It's called Amy's Back in Austin.
Sounds good.
A little different.
All right, folks. Tulane's home.
she went away. Was it the angry words or did she miss her mama? I don't know, but it don't feel right. I bet Amy's back in Austin and I'm missing her. Working 10 hours in the West Coast sun, make the day so long. Watching the moon crash into the ocean, long can grow so old. I remember how sweet it was. Where is she now? I'd love to know. I bet Amy's back. Working at Lazona Rosa Cafe. I remember the night that we lost and the day she went away. Was it the angry words or did she miss her mama? I don't know, but it don't feel right. I bet Amy's back in Austin and I'm missing her. I bet Amy's back in Austin. I bet Amy's back in Austin.
That was good stuff right there, man. I never heard that song before, but I already like to say that I like y'all's version better.
Well, thanks. Appreciate it.
So whenever it comes to doing a cover, what makes you say, I bet we could do that?
Man, if we like it, we'll try it. You know, that's just the way it is.
It's easy to learn.
Do y'all have a favorite cover that y'all do or anything? Or just one that you like to do?
Well, we like a lot of songs like this where we can throw harmony and stuff in. Now, if our third party, Matthew, would learn how to harmonize with me, we could do a lot better. I'm just throwing that out there to him. I mean,
call him out.
Hey, I know, call him out right here, so when he watches this.
Well, yeah, hopefully we can have him in back in next time with him moving a little bit closer to home, all that good stuff. So do y'all know Wagon Wheel or Freebird? You ever tried to pull out that one?
No, we know Wagon Wheel.
I mean, yeah, I know Freebird.
Yeah, I'd say that.
It takes a full band to pull that song off.
Yeah, with that 8-minute guitar solo, too, I mean, that's.
Yeah, no, I do a little bit of lead and stuff, but I'm not Freebird lead player.
We actually did it one time with I played with another cousin of ours. And, man, he's a phenomenal guitar player. He really is. And we done it one time at Fat Boys.
It was 13 minute long version? Man.
Acoustic, too.
He done a guitar solo on an acoustic guitar?
Yeah.
Whoa.
He's good. He's very good.
That is what's this guy's name?
Charlie Hall.
Check him out, folks. That's
wow. He's awesome. He is.
Good for him. I wish I had talent like that.
Oh, yeah, me too.
So you said that you write most mainly the originals and all that, right?
Yeah.
So an idea for a song, how does it come to you? Is it something that almost pops in your head, or does something, do you get an idea somewhere? How does that come about?
It pops in my head. I just, usually I can just play a tune. I can't really come up with words a whole lot, but if I get on guitar and I just start making up a tune or something, I'll just start spitting some words out. It may take me a week or two to come up with all of it, but I'll just keep working on it.
He does it a lot more than he says. He sends me about 5 new stuff. I mean, I don't hate it.
But it's just interesting, though, like how ideas come about, you know. That's even, see, we're dumb as a society still. Like, we're still stupid. Like, we don't even know where ideas come from. Scientists can speculate, but yeah, it's just kind of crazy how something will pop into your head, you know, and might make some good money. Who knows?
Yeah, I kind of, well, what I see in him usually a lot of time is just I might have part of it, a verse or something like that.
He's usually looking for help, and I'm useless when it comes to that.
Yeah, that's why I say it usually takes me a little longer because I don't have very much help.
how often? See, like, I do this a lot with jokes. Like, right before I go to bed, I'll get an idea. I'm like, oh, I have to write that down, you know, and then I'll look at it the next day and I'm like, what was I even thinking? That's not good at all.
I have an issue with that, but I keep my phone and where it has the notes, where you can go in and write notes down.
Yeah.
If I'm at work or doing something, and something comes to my head, I'll write down, it might just be a few words and I'll write it down. And then I'll have a tune in my head and everything. Then when I get to the house and I want to work on it, I'm like, what was the tune I was going to play with that? What was I even going to do with this? And then it'll sit to the side.
Yeah, and it's weird how it'll go like that. Ideas are a crazy thing. So what's the original that y'all are going to play for us today?
I think one I'll start off with is, I think it's the last one I wrote. It's a... I think cold beer, steel guitar, and a good party crab.
I like it.
And like I said, I write a little different. It's like older stuff. And most of my stuff's probably going to be about drinking. I mean, I'm going to be at a bar somewhere or doing something. So.
Well, that's mainly y'all setting. And, you know, I like how, the old stuff, old stuff or whatever, but it's making a comeback, you know. That's people are kind of tired of this bro country.
Oh, yeah.
Feel with lift up trucks and that mommy and daddy probably paid for and all that good stuff.
Jacked up truck.
Yeah. People are kind of getting tired of that, you know. We want to go back to the old Waylon and Chris Christopherson.
Absolutely.
And the good old days.
That's what a lot of people still like that stuff.
Yeah. And even people like, you know, like we were talking earlier about Tyler Childers and Sturgill Simpson, a lot of that same style is in their music. So if you have more people like them or even Chris Stapleton, you know, making it big and bringing that sound and that feel with them, hopefully it can bring stuff like that back.
Yeah.
Because I'd rather listen to stuff like this than Florida Georgia Line.
Give Gary Stewart a shout out because nobody ever gives him the attention he deserves.
Ain't that the truth, man? There's so many, you know. I mean, just all up and down U.S. 23, you can read those signs. Mm-hmm. I mean, heck, Dwight Yoakam, Loretta Lynn. I mean, you can go on and on and on.
I still like Willie Nelson.
I got to see him and Merle up at the arena last time they were in, like just about 2 months before Merle passed away. Willie, buddy, yeah, he's a... had kind of quite a crazy life, but he can still put on a heck of a show.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is that's keeping him going, but he's still going. It's important to have all them old heads like that still around. Love Willie Nelson.
Yeah, he's probably going to be around when we're gone. I don't know.
Listen, I'm pretty sure that him and, what's his name, Keith Richards, have been around just since the beginning of time, you know?
Yeah.
I seen this one meme one time. It's like God showing Adam and Eve around the garden and all that, and they're like, God, who's that? He's like, oh, that's Keith Richards. He was here when I got here.
That's a meme. I've not seen that one.
We had a guest in here a few weeks ago. He was like, you know how they say smoking a cigarette will take 7 years off of your life? Well, those 7 years goes to Keith Richards.
Yeah.
I thought that was a good one.
Like a rollover. In.
So what's the... I forgot. What's the original tune y'all are going to play for us?
Cold beer, steel guitar, and a good party crab.
I love that title. Here we go.
Let's hope the words go with it.
Hope I can play it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tulane's home again.
Steel toes and hard hand, what got me these working man blues? It's back-breaking, gut-busting work earned me scars and tattoos. I come from a long line of blue-collar, hard-working fools. What I need right now is a bar stool and a good country tune.
So crank up the jukebox and turn on some Hank. Play me some Hagger, bartender, pour me a drink. With a good country song, crank it up loud. But what we want right now is a cold beer, a steel guitar, and a good party crowd. Real hard to get where I am today. The radio ain't playing a single song makes me feel that way. I searched for some neon lights there just up ahead. Time to go in and see where this party begins. So crank up the jukebox and turn on some Hank. Play me some Hagger, bartender. With a good country song, crank it up loud. But what we want right now is a cold beer, a steel guitar, and a good party crowd. But what we want right now is a cold beer, a steel guitar, and a good party crowd.
I think we all need a little bit of that right now. That's some good stuff right there. How long does it usually take you to make a song? Is it something like, is it different for you? Do some songs, it's like that, but some songs will take a few months?
Yeah, some songs I can write in probably even a night.
Yeah.
Maybe take 10, 15 minutes I can throw one out. And then other times I may just get a couple words and it may take me a month or more to write a few words. I'll toss it to the side and then I'll come back to it later and then I'll start adding some more to it.
Yeah. it's funny how it goes like that. You know, it's almost like it was meant to be, you know, like a God or a universe, whatever people believe in out there, giving that idea to you, especially like when you can write it so quick. Mm-hmm. It's almost like it was just meant to be.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Well, I've really enjoyed y'all's music. For anybody else out there that wants to go check it out, maybe go to a show, keep up with updates of Tulane's Home, how do they do that?
We have a Facebook page, it's under Tulane's Home, and Instagram, it's under Tulane's Home. So there's two there. But my original stuff, we're not all playing together on it, but I need to eventually update it. But they want to listen to me, our originals. I have some on YouTube.
Okay.
It's under Tulane's Home, so.
All right. And you said you got two shows coming up that people can come out to and have a good time?
Yeah. That'd be at, on the 15th, which is on a Sunday. It's kind of different for us. It'll be on a Sunday evening, but that's at Clarissa's,
mm-hmm.
new place in Pikeville. Little country 11. Bar and grill. It's from 7 to 11 in the evening. And then Brick House be on the 21st. That's on a Saturday, and that's from 7 to 10.
And me and Steven are going to be down there eating some of those apple bourbon wings.
And, I love them. He ordered some, and he said, here, try one of these. And I got one. I said, waitress.
Man, that's the thing. I've never met anybody that's went to the Brick House, tried out anything on that menu, and said that it's bad. You can't find any bad food there. It's all good. So, yeah. And also, a big shout out to that Clarissa's place. I've heard about it, never been down there. But if y'all want to be like me, never checked it out, want to, be sure to come check out Tulane's Home. And, guys, thank y'all so much for coming in and looking forward to next time.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, well, thank you for having us.
Hey, anytime, anytime. Ladies and gentlemen, again, Jason Garrett, Stephen Lowe, Tulane's Home, and a big shout-out to Matthew, too.
Yeah, big shout-out to Matthew. He couldn't be with us today. Hopefully we get him in next time with us.
Oh, yeah, of course. But, guys, thanks again.
Thank you.
See you next week, folks. Boom.